Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. It is Wednesday, and that means that we are going to start looking at some buy opportunities for Thursday flipping investments. We're going to be talking about this stuff basically every single Wednesday because as we continue on through FIFA Ultimate Team, Wednesday nights into Thursdays, as we get weekend league rewards and the Division Rivals rewards on the market, it's a lot of packs, a lot of coins, and people go to upgrade their teams for that next weekend league. So today I want to talk about some possible investments that we can make this week and honestly just kind of talk about what is going to happen this week because I expect this week to be very similar to last week on Thursday with how we saw the market being rising a little bit, not much, but a little bit. And also, I also expect to see maybe a little bit more of a rise and maybe a little bit more panic selling because we're headed into another promo Friday on Thursday at the end of the day. So we're going to talk about Wednesday night and even into Thursday night a little bit too in this video today. So first thing I want to look at is what we could possibly be buying for flips today. Now, obviously it's Wednesday and that means there's a new team of the week coming out. So this team of the week is going to be going out of packs. A lot of these cards are up already, but if there's any sort of panic selling today, these out of packs informs from Team of the Week 1 and Team of the Week 2 that are meta and popular and usable. Kane, Haaland, Lewandowski, St. Maximin, Ronaldo Sanchez, Hernandez, Courtois, and Ali Watkins. I would watch all of those cards today as we do head into a new Team of the Week and all these cards going out of packs. Same thing with Team of the Week 1. If you see those guys drop, those could be great investments. But let's just talk about the time frame, right? Let's talk about the timeline of today on Wednesday and what we can expect. And then into the evening on Wednesday, what we can expect as well. So this is what I expect to happen in the next, you know, let's say 8 to 12 hours, right? As we head into the content time, as we head into 6 p.m. UK time on Wednesday. I've been doing a lot of quick flips, a lot of lazy, just buying cards and listing them for lazies. And it's been working pretty well on informs and on meta and popular players. And right now, as I'm recording this kind of, you know, it's actually about, what is it, like 3 in the morning UK time right now. It's like 10 p.m. my time. There's some cards that have kind of dropped down a little bit. This Gabriel Jesus, I bought at 70K. He was at 77K at one point today. Royce was at 80K. I bought these at 72, 73. Some cards kind of trailed off into the nighttime. I'm picking a few of these up, trying to flip them quickly overnight. Now, today for content, we have a big question mark, right? Yesterday, people thought there was going to be a pack supply SBC. We didn't really get one. We got the Witzel SBC. I'll talk about that in a bit too. But today, I think it's possible that we get another pack supply SBC or maybe even another ones to watch player SBC. Some sort of SBC, I think, should be coming today. Player of the Month Bundesliga could be a part of that as well. I don't expect I think Kramaric is supposed to win Player of the Month. I wouldn't expect his card to really do much to the Bundesliga. He doesn't get really good links to any Bayern or Dortmund players, and his card really isn't going to be that OP or meta, in my opinion. So hopefully it's cheap and it's a good SBC fodder, or it's just maybe a fun card to use and try out and then use as SBC fodder later. But that's the content that I would expect today. Some people are probably going to say and think that there's going to be some sort of pack supply SBC, or they feel like the market should drop. If that does happen, if there is a pack supply SBC that comes out, we could see the market drop a little bit in this afternoon. Basically from 6 p.m. UK on, what is going to be in people's minds, especially if there's no content or the content is overpriced and not a lot of people want to interact with it. What I think you're going to see is a lot of people start to sell off their squads, just like people do every single time a new rewards is coming out. Sunday night before squad battle rewards, people sell cards and then they rise afterwards. Last week on Thursday, people were selling cards before Division Rivals rewards. There wasn't a crazy inflation after the Rivals rewards on Thursday, just because there's not as many tradable packs opened. But this week there's weekend league demand, and last week that was not there, and I think that's going to pull the market a bit up more this week around the meta cards, and that's why I really want to just talk about in that late night Wednesday period, basically after 6 p.m. on Wednesday, watch the market until rewards time. There's going to be an opportunity. There's going to be some cards that get sold off, even cards that have been up a lot, right? We've watched a lot of these players rise in price. Rashford, Son, you know, even some of the lower rated cards like Dembele, like Gomez, these cards that we may have bought on Sunday and we were waiting for them to rise, they have kind of risen up, right? Pogba was 200, now he's 232. Militao with the price ranges is now 35. Even some of the cards out of packs continue to boom. But what I would say is watch the market for a bit of a sell-off this afternoon, or not this afternoon, Wednesday afternoon. Watch for a bit of the sell-off in the evening and, you know, a couple hours before rewards, because when you catch those sell-offs and when you catch a lot of open bids, we've talked about this right on Sunday nights. We're live on stream, twitch.tv/TheFutAccountant. Link is in the description. But what we do when we're on stream is we take a look at the market and we just notice that how many of these cards getting listed up are not just fresh items before rewards. What you're seeing is a lot of cards with chem styles and with a lot of open bids. You see a lot of listings like this. Somebody who has a chem style on their card, they're just selling it to get the coin, so they list with an open start price and they're undercutting to being one of the cheapest cards on the market. That is a pure sign of people selling cards and getting coins and getting liquid for a new reward set. Now, again, I know we don't have Foot Champs rewards. There's no reds, right? There's no link investments to the team of the week that we can really try to invest in right now. Those will come in next week, honestly, in later weeks. But it's all about meta cards. That's the stuff that's going to rise the most this weekend. Brazilian players, French players, Premier League. And using this top players, the popular players on Footbin, this list is going to help you so much in deciding which players do you want to kind of mess around with this week. Now, think about it again, right? A lot of people that have been on the game for a week, they've been building up coins, they've been trading, they've been opening packs, they've been doing SBCs, right? They've been upping their coin balances. So players that are in that cheaper range, you know, maybe I would say like the 15K and below range, some of those players, especially if they're strikers or even a left mid like Carrasco, these kind of guys might start to fall off a little bit. Rafinha probably going to start to fall off, especially after the weekend league sell-off. That's when I expect a lot of these cards to go down. You can already see some of them have gone down. Paulinho, Lamer, they've gone down. Itzel, he's got the hype from the SBC. Teixeira was once 9K during early access. He is down. So more and more people are going to be, you know, upgrading from a guy like Ndombele even. They're going to be upgrading to somebody like Fabinho. Or they're going to be upgrading to another midfielder in the Prem that is, you know, higher priced and higher rated. Like an Allen card, maybe even a Team of the Week item from somewhere along the line. That's why I really want you guys to focus on meta players that have risen already this week. A perfect example of that would be a Firmino. He's got some Team of the Week hype, so maybe not him. De Bruyne is really low right now. 330? What is going on with De Bruyne? Excuse me? He was like 360 all day today. This would be a card that if you have a lot of facilities, 370 all day, and he's 340, 330 right now. This might be an undercut and not actually on the market, but this would be like, that's the kind of undercuts that you're looking for Wednesday night, tonight, when you're on the market looking through these cards, right? What you're going to be able to see with a lot of the sell-off is it's just going to probably look at a kind of like a downward motion on Wednesday in the afternoon into the evening before rewards. And if you see a card like this, right? Ferland Mendy was 100K this week, and he's kind of risen up to 124,000 coins. If this guy is 110,000 coins tonight before rewards, snap him up. That'd be a great either buy for your team for the weekend or just an investment to flip. Because this card, if it rose once earlier in the week, it's going to rise again when people are done panic selling these cards because they want to see what they're going to get from rewards and, you know, what they're going to do with that. And then they build their teams back up again for weekend league. So this is a quick flip opportunity we have with these cards for Thursday flipping. Again, do I expect the market to go up a lot? I don't expect the market to go up a ton. It all depends. The investments this week all depend on the amount of panic that we have and the amount of sell-off that we have on Thursday night. Now, we've already started to see a little bit of a sell-off, right? Just on this normal night, a normal nightly fluctuation. I was looking at Royce earlier. Royce was 80,000 coins at one point today, and I've seen multiple listings in the low 70s in the past couple of hours. You can see he's got one page here at 76, 77K. I would expect a meta player like Royce to probably rise up 5 to 6K tomorrow, right? So if Royce is going to rise up 5 to 6,000 coins after rewards, but he drops 10K, let's say he's at 80,000 coins at 6 p.m. UK on Wednesday today when the content drops, and let's say he drops down to like low 70, 71, 72,000 coins, I think you can fully expect that card to drop to rise right back up to 80,000 coins where he was. But you're really going to want to find the cards on the market that are meta, popular, and that have those bigger drops. It's going to be hard to time. You're going to have to be looking for snipes on Footbin. You're going to have to be looking on the market as well because Footbin prices are not always accurate right now. But it all depends. The cards that have the biggest drop-off in the middle of the afternoon, and not middle of the, it's middle of the afternoon for me, but it's late night UK for you guys. Basically, in the early morning hours, the late night hours of the UK, the biggest drop-offs on meta cards, Premier League, Bundesliga, just look around. You can literally find those cards by clicking around inside a Footbin. And if it's higher rated, if it's meta, even a guy like Sissoko is probably going to have a bit of a drop off. But he's one of the best CDMs in the Prem, him and Fabinho. He's already risen from 43,000 to 50,000 coins this week. I would consider this guy a Thursday flip opportunist, right? Maybe tomorrow, right before rewards, he goes down to around 43, 44,000 coins. I think you can fully expect that card to go back up to 50,000 coins with demand and with people upgrading their teams. There's not a lot of packs that are open for Rivals Rewards. We found that out last week. There really was not a lot of supply on the Team of the Week cards. They didn't drop that much. And there wasn't a lot of supply on the market elsewhere because people are taking the coins and people are starting to take the untradeable packs as early as the second set of Division Rivals Rewards. People are already taking the second set of these rewards. So with that in mind, I don't think you're going to see a lot of supply on cards. I think when you really have to make your buy is before the rewards actually come out with the panic selling on the market. That's going to be the biggest thing, in my opinion, is making that buy time before that late night, you know, around midnight to 2 a.m. UK time. If you can stay up that late, if you can't, if you're going to wake up before rewards, like you can look at some prices before rewards as well. Maybe even during the first hour or two of rewards, you still might see some people that they get coins from something. A new Team of the Week card is out. That's going to affect some of these prices today as well. Like the new Team of the Week could affect some of these prices. A Firmino card that goes out of packs. Last week, what we saw with Haaland and with, who was it? It was Haaland that's in Team of the Week too. And Saint-Maximin as well. Two pretty hyped up players. Their gold cards were invested in for Team of the Week too. They dropped back down from where they were when the informs and when the Team of the Week was actually released. So if you have guys like Firmino that's inflated right now, let's say he gets into Team of the Week, right? What you could see is his card maybe drop back down 10,000 coins. Then you could buy that card and it watch it rise back up. And it is a meta popular usable gold card that's out of packs, but also meta popular and usable for people's weekend league teams. So that's another area you could watch. I mean, the Team of the Week this week is not looking super hot as of right now. This is a prediction by Patrick SimpleBlue88. Now with Foothead, Milinkovic Savage and Firmino are literally headlining his prediction for Team of the Week. So hopefully there's somebody else in there. I know Neymar earlier this evening had a hat trick performance and tied or surpassed the number of goals that R9 had as a Brazilian. So that's like a big record setting moment for Neymar. But his game was on a Tuesday night. So I don't know if that's enough heads up for EA. Usually Tuesday night games don't get informs. So I wouldn't expect to see Neymar unless EA pulled something out of somewhere crazy and gave Neymar a special card. But the Team of the Week is looking pretty in this week. So again, that's just going to mean more people are going to be going back to Team of the Week 2, Team of the Week 1 cards, and other just meta gold cards, right? Lewandowski's 309,000 coins right now. Maybe this is just an undercut on Footbin. No, it's not really. Look at these, 313, 318. He was like 325,000 coins most of the day today. Yeah, 325. He's actually was at 328 just before this, and he's dropped down to 309. This would be the type of card that if during the couple hours before rewards, you see his price down here again at 300,000 coins, I would expect to see this card back in the 320s, back in the 330K range. I love informs for flipping, Thursday flipping. I love them because they're rare, they're out of packs, and especially right now, this is the only type of like cool card with a dynamic image that you can get to put in your squad. So there is demand for all of these informs that are usable and somewhat meta. So that's one way you can look to trade too. What? Just basically watch the sell-off on the out-of-packs cards and on the popular meta golds tonight on Wednesday night. That's really all I had to say about this, and that's the most important part, is just watching that sell-off. Now, could you buy some link investments to Witzel? I was looking at Sancho, Kimmich, and Royce again tonight because some of these cards, like Royce, he was up at words of 80,000 coins today on PlayStation because people were buying this card to link up with Witzel, right? Same thing with Sancho. He was at like 38, 39,000 coins at a point earlier today before the Witzel SBC came out. And it looked like maybe some people were selling those investments tonight because he dropped back down to like 34, 35,000 coins. And even on like a fluctuation trade, I would buy this card at 35K. Just knowing that there's Weekend League rewards or there's Division Rivals rewards coming, Weekend League is on the horizon, and people might want this card for their Weekend League teams, whether they did Witzel or not, whether they did that SBC or not. This is like the best right wing in the Bundesliga. So people are going to want this card. Watch just for those drop offs today. Again, the Firmino would be a specific one that I would look at. Milinkovic Savage, even, I think, is up a little bit. If he does get an inform, I know he's not like a super crazy, like sought after card in the Serie A, but he's a pretty solid center mid. I think he's around 9K right now. People think he's going out of packs. He was 7K yesterday. So if Milinkovic does go out of packs and his card goes from like, let's say he's 10K tomorrow morning, goes from 10K all the way back down to like you know, 8,000 coins or 7,500, that could be an investment opportunity right there, with people selling off the gold cards that they're expecting to rise as they go out of packs, but the undercuts just keep coming in and coming in and coming in, and you see them drop even lower. Now, the most important thing, again, to say with this is focus on Premier League and on players that people have already bought for their teams and they sell off before rewards, right? Like when you see a player like a Wijnaldum going down or a Rashford or a Son, it's not because people are selling those cards because they want to upgrade further past them. Most likely it's not that way. They're just selling to get liquid, to build a different team, depending on what they pack with their rewards or what the market does, or maybe they're just selling because they know Once to Watch is coming on Friday. But I would expect a lot of these cards to rebound because there is that weekend league demand and there is that weekend league hype there. So again, I feel like I said this over and over, but the big thing today is meta, popular, and the bigger the drop on Wednesday night into Thursday morning before rewards UK time, watch that drop, buy the drop, trust that it's going to rebound because it is meta, it is popular, and if it rose again this week, again, like a guy like Joe Gomez, if you see him at 100,000 coins right before rewards, and he was 100,000 coins this week, he went all the way up to 120. If he goes back down, and remember your EA tax, because if it's a little bit of a drop, you have to remember the EA tax is there. But if you see that drop, that's just a huge, huge opportunity to buy. This is going to be the last week of Thursday flipping where we have to worry about not as much supply being put on the market and not as many coins being put on the market because there's no weekend league rewards. Next week with Thursday flipping, it's going to be a true Thursday flipping investments week where we'll look at out of packs informs, links to the new team of the week cards, and it's just going to be so much better. It's going to be so much better with weekend league rewards because that's going to put so many more coins on the game with those rewards being distributed to so many people. It's going to be so much better. So I can't wait for that. It's going to be good. This week though, I still think the market rises, and a day as we head into the second week of the Ones to Watch promo on foot. So again, other content I would expect for today, maybe a pack supply SBC that could hinder the market and drop the market down as well and just make it more prime for buying some of these meta cards for people that will be buying them for their weekend league squads after rewards, and then also Bundesliga player of the month. So that's the video for today, boys. If you did enjoy it, smash a thumbs up on it. If you have any questions, drop them down below in the description, or in the comments, not the description, and subscribe to the channel for new boys. All right, we're going for 20K. Would appreciate your help in getting there. Thanks for watching. It's been Nate the Foot Accountant. I will catch you guys later. Peace.